I should have bought hot Cheetos. I had some.
Oh, I have some on my desk.
Do you really?
Yeah. It's just so
just
far
text
away.
Buckner to like, hey, can you bring some hot Cheetos?
It's probably best. I don't know. They will get sued.
Oh, they will come after us. Yeah,
you know? Ooh, ouch. Ooh, so spicy. So hot.
I'm Does really it burn good? Good?
It burns good. Oh. Which we're going to bring that back. We're going to bring it to later.
Okay.
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 Hey, everyone. Jalissa's here. We saw Flamin' Hot. Mm-hmm. This is the like semi-biographical.
Yeah, it's based on the life
of
Richard Montañez.
Yes.
But it's not like a biography. Yeah.
It's interesting. Mm-hmm. And his claim to fame is
the person behind the best chips in the world.
Yeah, one of the biggest selling snack foods of all time, the Flamin' Hot Cheetos.
Heck yeah.
Which we were both big fans of.
Super big fans of.
Yeah. Not just middle school us.
No, like entirely to this day.
Like I got some on my desk
like
right now.
Like lime hot Cheetos, yes. Regular Flamin' Hot Cheetos, the puffs, the jalapeno ones,
yes.
The regular classic Cheetos. Yeah. Honestly, all of them. Didn't really like the elote ones. I wouldn't really feel
like I don't like spicy Doritos.
Yeah, it's different.
There's just something about the
Cheetos. Hot Cheetos with cream cheese though. Tried it?
Oh no.
Super
well,
good.
Well, now this has turned into Super a food
good.
Review.
Hello.
You food show.
Hello.
But yeah, so this movie, it's, I'm gonna rattle off some names. It's directed by Eva Longoria of Desperate Housewives.
Mm-hmm.
And
she's also directed like episodes of Jane the Virgin.
Yes.
Grand Hotel was a show she brought back. Only got one season.
That's okay.
Really enjoyed
it. Sorry, Eva. But she's on to bigger and better things.
Heck yeah.
You've got a pretty like, at least the two stars. They're in things, but maybe this is kind of their first big like in the spotlight kind of thing. You got Jesse Garcia as Richard.
He did so good.
You got Annie Gonzalez as his wife, Judy.
She's on a Netflix show, Hentified.
Yeah.
She did a great job there.
And then you got Emilio Riviera, who I believe is in one of the Sands of Anarchy shows.
He is.
Mm-hmm. You got Dennis Haysbert. We all know him as the State Farm guy.
I've been waiting for this movie, as you know. I'm a big Eva Longoria fan. Like, I want to try her tequila. I want to support Eva Longoria in any way that I can. I love her. When I meet her, I'm going to cry. So I was very excited for this movie, the representation of it, and it had a larger impact than I originally went into knowing it was going to have. So I liked it a lot.
I think, you know, to that, there are a lot of this movie, which it does really well, and I know a few other movies are kind of embracing this kind of, it's in English, and then, you know, you do have moments where they're talking in Spanish, mm-hmm. and they have, like, subtitles, but where some of the Spanish is kind of inserted just mid-sentence.
Yeah.
And there's no, like, there's no subtitle to give you an idea of what, it just kind of, it becomes like a natural, like, you know what they're talking about, just through, if you don't speak Spanish, through context clues, and then you really do see, like, a really great representation of these people who are speaking English, and they're kind of, like, merging these two dialects, these mm-hmm. two languages into how, you know, people normally speak too.
Yeah.
You know? And I thought that was really cool.
That was dope, especially because Eva Longoria is Mexican-American. Yeah. And that is like, she talks like that. Even in like interviews or stuff like that, she'll switch between Spanish and English. And I think it really, really highlighted the Mexican-American like Chicano culture.
Yeah.
Because I'm Mexican-American, we always talk like that. Like Spanglish is 1,000% more than like just speaking Spanish, just speaking English. Yeah. And she did it so well to where it was really fun to like see that.
Because
normally, like you said, we see subtitles or they'll stay talking in Spanish the whole time. It was like specifically also the slang was Mexican-American slang. So I loved it, or Mexican slang.
It makes you feel like a part. Like, so the whole movie's kind of Richard giving this narration.
Yeah, it was very inviting.
Yeah, and so he is like, not only are you hearing like his thoughts, you are like, it just, so you're already very close to him, and then you have that element with his family and his wife and the way that they're speaking to each other, even the way he's speaking to other people, mm-hmm. where he doesn't really care who he's around, that's like who he is the whole time. I think Jesse Garcia like just, it is really great.
He did such a good job. And you know what was really fun? When they would be like the Pepsi people sitting there talking, and they would, he would explain all of it in Spanish. And it reminded me when I summarize things and I'm like, oh, he was definitely giving this. And then he's like, wait, if y'all don't get it, like, here's what happened.
Yeah. And Eva like kind of takes this story and she You know, it's not just like you're straight up. I thought a lot about Air during this movie.
Me too. Because
yeah. It kind of feels, it's like, oh, it's a big product. Yeah. It's the thing that kind of saves the company.
I think it was done better than Air.
And I think it kind of gives you just know more about the people in the, mm-hmm. in this movie. It's kind of, you're invested in Richard. Richard has these moments where, like the boardroom scenes, or like there's a scene where he... it's like a fantasy, and he's like beating up a guy in a factory.
And for a second, you think, "Wait, did that happen?" Yeah, and it's even though you know how this ends.
Yeah, and it's just I think it's just if it's more fun mm-hmm. than like Air is great,
it's but very
this
serious.
This feels very like personal and feels very like and it's perfect because the story, you know, there's been some kind of like back and forth on. Who really invented the hot Cheeto? Like who came up? Like when it happened? Mm-hmm. And it was kind of a nice way to blend this world of like, yeah, like this happened. The details may be a little, you know, maybe a little blurry.
But here's the person who like it really inspired it and the culture and that inspired it.
And they take it like instead of being like a weird. Like kind of Facebook social network movie. Yeah. They took the idea of like, it's not about the chips. It's about like the community he reached.
Yeah, and the like impact stuff like that. Because I thought about Air too, and I think Air was great, but this one was like funny and emotional more than Air was. Like at the end, like I wanted to cry.
Oh, you know, when he calls and he's like, I'm gonna need more ties.
That
I was like,
And then him and Judy are still together at the end. But this was Eva's directorial debut. And I know you review movies more than I do. This is my debut reviewing a movie. What did you think of her? I know she's directed TV episodes, but this was like her movie debut being a director. What were your thoughts compared to other directors you've like reviewed?
I think that Eva does a really good job of not making it about her. You know, so many people can come in and they can say, hey, I want to do this. We're going to do something really cool and fancy, and I'm going to have my own style. But for her to say, to be so invested in, I think it's big for a director to say, story over what I want to do. Let's tell the story the best way we can without distracting with like a crazy like montage or a crazy mm-hmm. long shot or a crazy, you know, like camera tilt. You know, it's a movie that you almost... You can't like see the directing in it.
Yeah.
And I think that, and where some would say, well, that doesn't sound like a good thing. I think it is a good thing.
It was like she was really invested in the story it was sharing, the people. Because everywhere she goes promoting this, she takes the two stars, like the main characters. Yeah. She takes them with her. Even to throw out the first pitch, she had them with her on the mount. Like she's very like,
yes.
Here's everybody's work. Yeah. This is not just about me. It could have been really long.
Yeah.
And it could have took a lot. Because like Air, it took us a long time to finally get to that shoe. Didn't take us long to get to the hot Cheeto.
Well, I think it's almost like, because I think what it is too is it is so much of Richard connecting with the community. He's fighting for something too. Mm-hmm. You know, he's like.
For himself,
everyone's going to lose their jobs. I want to provide for my family. But also I want to grow as a person.
Mm-hmm.
And so again, like, while like the hot Cheeto part doesn't even come in until the last 30, 40 minutes.
Yeah. But I felt like we got there pretty fast. Yeah.
You're invested and the performances are really great. It's done in a way that is fun.
It's a good movie.
Yeah. On a scale of like 1 to 10, 10 being like, ooh, burns bad. What did I say? 1 being burns bad.
10
being burns good. How many out of 10 would you give it?
Burns good. Yeah. 10. It was a 10 for me. It was such a 10. It was like my little eyes just sparkled. I think if I watched this as a kid, I would have like freaked out. Because I freaked out watching Selena as a kid. Because I was like, oh, she's Mexican. And these are two totally different movies. But like the representation, I was like, oh my gosh, she's Mexican American. And then here, like that for me was like so big.
Yeah.
So big. And then the fact that it was from Eva Longoria. She's from Texas. Yeah. Like it just... The representation, the storytelling, hot Cheetos, burns good. 10 for me.
I really enjoyed it. It was nice. It was breezy. Performance is really great. I'd go like 7.5 out of 10.
Okay.
Burns good, you know?
Yeah, 1,000%.
So, I think, I don't know. It's hard to say like what you would add to it. It's just a really good movie. Yeah.
I don't think it was bad. I'm glad it wasn't.
Should we have had more hot Cheetos? Should we have had more cuts of people's fingers with the Cheeto dust?
Yeah.
What a great shot.
1,000. Also, can we bring back the bags?
The bags.
Because those were like really cool. Yeah. And then something else, you know, the one who plays his little son when he's like, the burn's good, burn's yeah. bad. And he's like, I love Elote, I love it. He was so yes. cute. He's a TikTok kid.
Oh.
He got famous on TikTok, him and his dad.
Well, then we need to get, I mean, you're on TikTok. I need to get on TikTok.
Yeah, he got famous. Maybe I'll be cast in a movie. This turns really sad fast, but him and his dad like made all these TikToks, and then he got casted on the Lopez versus Lopez
yeah.
show. He plays George Lopez's grandson, and then his dad actually died of cancer, but he's still like chasing his little dream. Yeah. And so I was like, this is a really exciting moment for like his family and stuff, and Eva casted him.
That's exciting.
I know. He started on TikTok, and then he was on Flamin' Hot.
Good
what
movie.
A good movie.
Good movie.
Eat some hot Cheetos. Eva Longoria.
Call Calissa. Go watch this movie. And tell us what you think.
Yeah. So, review it.